Hey church, it's been so good to see everybody online and at our outdoor services recently. I'll tell you, it's been such a blessing that God gave us that property to the north so that we can continue to meet in the midst of all this and even provide some shade. And so we say that we are a church without walls. And I'll tell you, it's just been so wonderful to see everybody live that out. First in our midst, caring for one another, running errands, making phone calls, serving on the care team, all these things. And then seeing our eagerness to care for the world around us. And I think of the prayer walk that we did a few weeks back and just how good it felt to be about the mission of Jesus again and get out into this community. So it's been a long time. It's been about 22, 23 weeks since we've met inside the auditorium as a church. Actually, this started, if you can believe it, all the way back on March 15th when we launched our first online services that you could view. It was a good experience for all of us, it really was, because we could see that we don't have to have a building and we don't have to have these walls in order to be a church. So we did that for 12 weeks, almost 3 months. And then I'll never forget the day that we moved outdoors and we could see one another and be together as a physical church in a physical space. Once again, we were so excited to see you all. And once again, God blessed us with the land to be able to do that. What I want to tell you today is that we believe the next step for us as a church is to move indoors and have service once again in our auditorium. Now, it's going to look different, of course. We're going to have two services because we believe we need to divide up the population so that we can socially distance better. So we're going to have a service at 9:15 in the morning and 11 o'clock. Those are going to be 1 hour on the dot. We're going to be very punctual with that. And so you can come here and actually worship physically in this space. And we will continue to do our online services. We'll continue to stream those online. In fact, we've got the technology to do it now. That is here to stay. And for those of you who enjoy the outdoor environment, you know, and it's a sad thing to see that go, we're going to continue to provide opportunities more than usual to meet outside. So we'll give you more details on that coming up. So let me give you a couple reasons why we believe we need to take this move as a church. And so first, we need a consistent and reliable plan for meeting. We get it that the Sunday morning service, that's not all that a church is, but it is a really important part of our identity and who we are and rallying together around God's mission for us. So we've had to cancel twice since we launched outdoor services because of rain. There's been a few other days, it's been very hot and humid, and we were on the verge of canceling. It's really close to needing to do that. So just to uphold our commitment to gather together and to pray and to worship and hear the teaching, we believe we need something more consistent moving indoors. Secondly, we do believe that we connect better with you and better with visitors in an indoor, more contained environment. And we get it. A lot of really good fellowship happened in the outdoor services, and I don't want to discount that. It's been really good stuff. But the feedback I've gotten from the staff, and I've experienced this myself, is it just is easier to connect with all of you and to have processes in place where we can connect with visitors when we're inside, when we're in that environment. So those are our reasons why we believe we need to make this move. But let me say this, we would not do this if we didn't believe that it was safe to do so and we could do so in a responsible manner. So over 70% of churches are now meeting indoors around the country. And the vast, vast majority, it's really encouraging stuff, are doing so safely and without outbreaks and without community spread. And I get it, you can turn on the television and see news stories otherwise, but the churches you see there, I mean, that is the exception to the rule. The vast majority are doing this safely. And God's walked with us so faithfully in this road thus far. And we believe He's going to continue to walk with us faithfully. And so the practices, you're familiar with them, that churches who are doing this successfully, having indoor services successfully, are number one, wearing masks, universal masks. And we know this is a government mandate in our state. This is something we're going to do anyway, but not just because it's a government mandate, because we believe that masks help keep one another safe, and it is a way of loving one another. So we're going to do that. And secondly, of course, this is old hat by now, but staying 6 feet apart from one another. So the best studies from the World Health Organization, the CDC, show that both of these practices, masking and social distancing, reduce your chance of getting COVID by 80%. 80% if you're around someone who's infected individually. When you pair them together, it makes for a very, very safe interaction with other people. So again, we believe that it can be done safely. But here's what I want to leave you with. I get it that not everybody's going to agree with this decision. Okay, and some of you are going to feel the need to stay at home. And I want to tell you this, there is no judgment, there is no condemnation for any decisions that we make, these personal decisions we make, based on just the intricacies of our lives, who we're caring for, who we're interacting with, our own health condition, and all these things. Because we want the church to be a place not of condemnation, but a place of unity. And when we gather around the mission and the teaching and the reality of Jesus Christ, He creates this thing called unity in our midst. It's the best thing a church can have, despite our differences. You hear that? Differences over masking, social distancing, and COVID and the pandemic. All these things can exist within a church that is unified. And so the key to doing so is consistently calling upon the Holy Spirit and showing one another grace. And that's the challenge for me. It's a challenge for all of you. Let's show one another grace and care and concern despite our differences. And again, God has been so faithful to us. We believe He will continue to be faithful to you. Blessings to you. Blessings to all the families, individuals out there. And we'll see you Sunday.